welcome to the Guinness Soccer Six Championships here at the GMEX Centre in Manchester. This is the richest indoor soccer championship ever held in this country. £250,000 worth of prize money at stake. And my word, what a lineup we have for you. For the first time ever, all 20 First Division clubs, plus Manchester City from the Second Division. Now this is the format. For the first 3 days, six unseeded clubs play in two mini leagues, three clubs per league. The winners of those leagues then play off against each other for a place in Wednesday night's final stages when they're joined by three seeded clubs. The three seeded clubs being the Football League champions Liverpool, the FA Cup holders Wimbledon, and the reigning Soccer Six champions Nottingham Forest. Your commentators John Motson and Tony Gubber will keep you in touch with the rules throughout the competition, but really there are four main rules that you ought to know about, and here they are. First of all, there is no head height restriction in Soccer Six. Secondly, players who misbehave themselves, they face instant punishment and the sin bin. Third, there is a three-line rule which prevents the ball being hoofed from one end to the other, ensuring instead a constructive build-up. And fourthly, there is what they call a sixth-man rule, which basically means that one player from each team must remain in the opponent's half, and this helps obviously prevent packed defences. So here are the first round groups. In Group A, a really strong group, Spurs, Aston Villa and Everton. And in Group B, Newcastle, Coventry and Charlton Athletic.
Short.
So 2-2 the scoreline. Now it's time for the third side in Group B, Charlton, to make their entrance. Their first game is against Coventry.
Charlton Athletic stayed overnight after playing at Old Trafford yesterday. Their manager Lenny Lawrence has brought a good strong squad, captained by number 5 Peter Shirtliff. So away go Coventry, playing from the right in the first half in the sky blue. Charlton Athletic with number 8 there, Paul Mortimer, on the ball now in the first minute, and he's found Peak, and Andy Peak shoots over the bar. Here's Phillips. Actually. Now Keith Thompson. John Humphrey, good strong run by him. Players to right and left for him. Still Humphrey, he's gone for goal! And how well he found the back of the net there, John Humphrey. Lenny Lawrence's team take the lead. David Speedy probably had his view obstructed by Greg Downs there, I would have thought. Greg Downs was standing in front of the ball and it went really between him and the goalkeeper.
Get across, Greg.
Peak to Reed. Charlton making a substitution while this is going on. Steve Britt has come on. Experienced player wearing number 6. Oh, and he's in a good position straight away. Well, the surprise element of substitutions in Soccer 6 is an important tactic for the managers. They can just push a man on and suddenly he's right in the forefront, as Grit was there. Here he is again. Humphrey. Now, Peter Shirtliff for Charlton. And Speedy missed that and Mortimer was in. And, oh, an own goal! Steve Sedgley. Well, I don't think Charlton could have expected to go two up in quite that manner, and I don't think Steve Sedgley wants to see that again. We'll see it again. He'd warded off the challenge from Mortimer and promptly poked the ball between Speedy and the post. Quite extraordinary, this. He'd done the hard bit. They got away from the number 8, and now look what happens. Own goal. So Charlton have a handsome lead. For the Londoners, Charlton Athletic have a 2-0 lead here against Coventry City, and I would imagine that means David Speedy, who's playing in goal in this Soccer Six for Coventry, will spend a lot of time coming out to help his outfield players. For the moment, it's a sin bin offence by Andy Peake, who went back into his own half when he should have been staying in Coventry's half. So Charlton are reduced to 5 men for 2 minutes. So let's see if Coventry can make the extra man tell with Steve Livingston here, number 8. Now here's a real opportunity for Coventry because Charlton are down to five men, four outfield players, and they've given the ball away, and Phillips, good save by Boulder. Livingston. Number seven here is Martin Lane, back again to Brian Burrows. Touched in for Clark. Grit for Charlton. And they'll need some of that in the next couple of minutes because they're a man short. And here goes Michael Bennett. And it's a goal. 3-0. And Michael Bennett, breaking away, just stroked that ball underneath David Speedy, who was well out of his goal, it has to be said. And I don't think that's what he'd be doing every day of the week, because this is very much a one-off for David Speedy, who likes to play in goal in training. Let's again look where Speedy is now. Ryan Kilcline has come on as well for Coventry. That's a foul, is it? Advantage applied. Phillips, Speedy. Off the board, chance here for Livingston. Go on, back you go. Free kick there, Lee Byrne was checked. Danny Lawrence's team here in a very strong position. Here's Lee Byrne. He's back there now for the time being, but he'll soon come out again, I'm sure of that. This is Livingston. Here's Speedy. On to Thompson. Lane. Thompson again. Livingston. Now can Charlton get at the other end while David Speedy is still stranded? That's the question. Lee Byrne may just achieve it here. He's held off Thompson. The empty net is beckoning. And there's an easy goal for David Campbell. Speedy was way, way out. And while he was at the other end of the field, Lee Byrne broke away, squared it past Downs, and Campbell made it 4-0 to Charlton. And Lenny Lawrence looks at the scoreboard and at the clock. And a very handsome victory it is too for Charlton Athletic here. They've worked hard at their game in this six-a-side. They've scored the goals at the other end. And they've beaten Coventry City by an emphatic margin of 4-0.
So that's the situation in Group B after two games. It leaves the group precariously balanced before the final game. Charlton only need to draw. Newcastle must win to top the group.
Newcastle United starting lineup then. Dave Besant in goal, John Cornwall, Kevin Scott, John Hendry, Liam O'Brien and Darren Jackson. As for Charlton, they start with Bob Boulder, John Humphrey, Mark Reid, Peter Shirtliff, Paul Mortimer and Andy Peake. So Newcastle in the stripes with John Hendry making an early advance on Bob Boulder's goal. And here's John Humphrey, who played well for Charlton in their opening match and scored. Number two. Here's Mark Reid. Foul on the far side, spotted there by referee Alan Flood. It was John Cornwall who was the offender. And it's a free kick to Charlton. Here's Paul Mortimer. O'Brien. Hendry. It's O'Brien. This is Kevin Scott. O'Brien again. Oh, off the boards for Darren Jackson. Back to Hendry. O'Brien. Good play. Oh, it's a really good goal by Liam O'Brien. Back in Manchester where he was playing for United until just a few weeks ago. He's now joined Newcastle and the Irishman showed a bit of talent here, brushing past the defender and firing it in there from an angle. and Bob Boulder was beaten by the sheer power of that shot. So Newcastle United, who find themselves here having to go for the win in order to qualify for tonight's final, a draw would suffice for Charlton. Newcastle have got to force the pace, and they've done just that right from the start, and they've taken the lead. This is Humphrey. And Archie Gourlay for Newcastle. Good little battler. Here's Kevin Scott. Jackson. Now Hendry. Little deflection. Jackson. 2-0. Newcastle lead. And Darren Jackson snaps one up from really close in. This was made by John Hendry. Good use there of the plexiglass. And look where Jackson is, just to tuck that in. Hendry used the glass really well to get the rebound away from the goalkeeper, and Jackson the scorer. So at this stage of the evening, the Geordies look as though they might qualify for the final. They're leading here by 2-0, but Charlton have got other ideas, and there's Reid, and there's one of those ideas. Mark Reid pulls one back straight from the restart for Charlton. Besant had no chance. Now this was Mortimer doing exactly that, back off the boards, and he had no chance with the shot, but Besant might have collected the earlier one. As it is, it's 2-1. This is O'Brien. Mirandinha is on the surface now, number 8. And he's managed to open things up a little bit for Newcastle. Archie Gourlay on the far side, free kick. Foul by Steve Gritt. Pulled back for O'Brien, and it hits Shirtliff. Balls coming in from all over the place there. They'll need to get rid of one of them at least. Newcastle on the attack with O'Brien. And here's Mirandinha. Nearly an own goal by Shirtliff. An eventful first half here. And what a lovely ball that was by Gritt to Mortimer. Kevin Scott was there to tuck it back to Dave Besant. Lenny Lawrence's team showing some really good skill tonight. Here's Scott. Lee Kane. Newcastle moving the ball about well. And that deflection takes the sting out of the shot from Mark Gill. But Bob Boulder's in a bit of a corner here. And the clearance only finds O'Brien. And here's Mirandinha. And Boulder's there. Mirandinha again. Doesn't normally need much of an invitation to get his shots in, the Brazilian. And he had two pokes there, and he might have another one here. It's three in a row for Mirandinha. Here's Michael Bennett. Scott. John Hendry. And Gill is there, and Boulder made sure that he got there first.
Back to the ball, boys, please.
Newcastle United 2, Charlton 1. Under 2 minutes left in the first half. O'Brien and Jackson for Newcastle, and Reid for Charlton, the scorers. But just bear in mind that Charlton know that a draw would be enough for them. Newcastle have to win. And at the moment they are winning. This is John Cornwall. Forward to Lee Payne, number 6. Well played by Hendry. Ooh, that wasn't far away. Mark Payne, former Barnet player. He's missed out there, but he gets a chance to win it back and concedes the free kick. John Cornwall has upset the referee a little bit, and he's been sent to the sin bin for time wasting. John Cornwall kicked the ball away when the free kick was given, and Alan Flood gave him the two-minute penalty in the sin bin. Newcastle are down to five men. And there's a chance for Mortimer for Charlton. So, now then, with just about 45 seconds left in the first half, Charlton, who are 2-1 down, have an extra man at the moment and will have for the rest of this half. But it's Newcastle on the attack with Hendry. Well, Michael Bennett's tackle, it was judged to be legal. He's left Hendry on the ground. Andy Peak off Kevin Scott. Bennett again against Besant. Good lively match, this one. There goes Andy Peak with Gill. Went back, Mortimer. Peak. Mortimer. Oh, in the end, he made a present of that to Dave Besant. And you can see from your screen, it's just about half-time. And Newcastle United lead Charlton by 2-1 in a match that Newcastle have to win in order to qualify for the final. So, Charlton, whose weekend has been spent entirely in Manchester, having played at Old Trafford yesterday, they're now in the GMEX Centre, and early in the second half they get a free kick. Carl Leeburn was fouled. Campbell. Newcastle have started the second half still a man short because John Cornwall is completing his 2 minutes playing time, not playing for him of course, but 2 minutes of match time in the sin bin. Here's Shirtliff for Charlton. Oh, they've got two over, and Peake's there, and Leeburn's there, and that's a goal for Charlton. They've got back to 2-2 while Newcastle are still a man short. The two-goal lead is wiped out, and Carl Leeburn gets in here and just gets the touch ahead of the defender to make it 2-2. Leeburn will claim that, although there are a couple of Newcastle ricochets in there as well. 2-2, and wide open here. Now, if it stays like this, Charlton... Free kick to Newcastle. Charlton would qualify, but Newcastle have to go for the win, and the balance of the match is completely changed now. Cornwall has completed his suspension. In fact, he's back on the surface. Mirandinha is also back on now for Newcastle. And this is big Carl Leeburn for Charlton. Well played by Shirtliff. This is Reid. And now it's Peak. Oh, and Leeburn's there again. Players really smart at snapping up these rebounds off the boards at times. Cornwall, Mirandinha. Reid. And again. Peaks outside him. Humphrey. Shirtliff. Well played.
Leeburn.
Humphrey. Reid. Humphrey again. Peak. Leeburn. Mirandinha. Oh, good run by the Brazilian. It came off Reid. Charlton then having to defend here. It's 2-2. At the moment, the odds are in Charlton's favour. Oh, an alien own goal by Shirtliff. They wouldn't have been then. Did he go into the shaded area, I wonder, Shirtliff? I don't think it was spotted by the referee, but I think we had a nearly an own goal and very close to a penalty there in that goal area. Newcastle still on the attack, though. Mirandinha. Oh, well played, and that's... Oh, Gourlay. Good save by Boulder. All sorts of activity there in the Charlton goal area. Charlton beat Coventry 4-0 in their first match, so if they were to draw here, Charlton, they would qualify. Newcastle only drew their first match, so they have to win this one to go into the final tonight. That's why it's so exciting, and here's Merendinia, and that's the goal they wanted! Liam O'Brien! They had to go for the win, and now they're ahead. Merendinia suddenly carved something out there, and O'Brien accepted the present. It's 3-2 to Newcastle, and this eventful match swings back again their way. But this is Paul Mortimer, and this is Shirtliff, and that's Lehman! And we're back to 3-3. Really good stuff here between Newcastle and Charlton. Two goals in a minute, set up by Shirtliff, converted by Lehman, and Charlton are back in the driving seat as both teams make substitutions. Still over 3 minutes to go, and I would say up to now it's the best match of the night. Number 10 is Darren Jackson. Charlton on the attack though, it's David Campbell. Lee Burns in the middle, could this be his hat-trick? Good challenge by Kevin Scott. Lee Payne. That's the way to make a substitution. Give him the ball straight away. He ran onto it there. Michael Bennett. Lenny Lawrence has really got this sussed, hasn't he? It's under 2 minutes left. It's 3-3. And Newcastle have got to go, press on and try and get another goal. This is John Hendry. O'Brien. Good effort. Bob Boulder's going to have to hurry. He had Payne coming in and Hendry as well. O'Brien shot. Oh, good turn by Mark Lee. He's been left on the ground by O'Brien's challenge. This is Humphrey though. And on the far side, a great chance for 4-3. And it may still be off Scott. No. Michael Bennett had the first shot for Charlton. And a good effort it was too. This is Darren Jackson for Newcastle. This is how Soccer Six should be played. Fast and furious. Lots of attacking opportunities. Plenty of good passing. And full-blooded attempts by everybody, including Dave Besant. Here's Jackson. Boulder comes out at the other end. Besant's got to go back now. Under a minute left. 3-3. Newcastle have to get the other goal if they're going to qualify. Merendinia. O'Brien. Hendry. Charlton defending well. This is David Campbell, number 4, now that he's got support to his right. This is number 7, Michael Bennett. It still is. Darren Jackson. Merendinia. Now this could be their one of their last chances, Newcastle. It's still Merendinia. Shoots wide. Number 7, Hendry. Merendinia, surely. Oh, what a good chance for the Brazilian. Let's give the credit to Bob Boulder. That save may have gained Charlton a place in tonight's final. And it has. Charlton are through thanks to the 3-3 draw. And that save by Bob Boulder earns his side a great deal of money, because that qualification for the final means that Charlton will earn at least another £7,000 for their night's work. And they qualify and Newcastle go out after an exciting game.
Well, what a dramatic match. Newcastle had their chances to snatch victory and a place in the playoff, but Charlton held on for the draw that they needed to win Group B. Charlton finishing 2 points ahead of Newcastle, with Coventry in third place. So now to the playoff itself, with a place in Wednesday's final stages at stake, remember. It's Aston Villa, winners of Group A, against Charlton, the Group B winners.
Aston Villa's starting lineup then: Nigel Spink, David Platt, Gordon Cowans, Paul Birch, Kevin Gage and Stuart Gray. And their opponents, Charlton, Bob Boulder, who made that vital save to get them into the final, John Humphrey, Mark Reid, Peter Shirtliff, Paul Mortimer and Carl Leeburn. So, no score at half-time, but plenty at stake in this Sunday night final of the Guinness Soccer Six. Team that wins here comes back on Wednesday for the gala final and earns a lot more money too. Charlton on the attack at the beginning of the second half then, in the red shirts and white shorts, playing now from the right. Reid, Shirtliff, Campbell, hoping for a rebound that might have favoured Bennett. As it is, it's Aston Villa who break away. Real tussle between Gray and Grit there. Cowans plays it back to Alan McInally. Now Gray. Daly. Comes up to make the point that we could have a penalty shootout if this final was drawn. But there's still plenty of time for goals here in the second half. Campbell for Charlton. Reid. Now if Shirtliff wins this, Charlton could be in a good position. Shot was by Michael Bennett. Downs for Aston Villa. Gets it back from David Hunt. Still Cowans. Here's Daly. Good shot. And Bob Boulder down at full stretch. But only as far as Cowans the clearance. McInally. Daly. Hunt. Looks for Platt on the far side. Shirtliff is the defender. Gets Charlton moving through David Campbell. Michael Bennett the target here. Back into Reid. Rolled across to Shirtliff. Oh, Bennett couldn't convert the rebound. Campbell's shot came back off the boards. A bit too quickly for Bennett there. Fouled by Grit. On McInally. Charlton about to make another substitution. Grit's gone off and Peake's come on. And Aston Villa are in possession with Gordon Cowans. Daly. Quick step. He's found Gareth Williams off the boards and Daly in, but Shirtliff away. Now then, Michael Bennett, he's away here. Missed the target, but Campbell didn't. And a good save by Spink. Bennett on the floor. Well, the pace is picking up a little bit now in the second half. Aston Villa have possession. This is McInally. Oh, Cowan's shot and Boulder superbly saves it. Bob Boulder is becoming quite a hero tonight for Charlton. Hurt his elbow there, but it was a fine piece of goalkeeping. Forward by Mortimer. Here's Bennett. And that's the first goal. And Charlton are in the lead. Michael Bennett set up for him by Paul Mortimer. And a good finish that. Mortimer plays the ball through with his left foot. And Bennett here turns inside. 1-0. Daly for Aston Villa at the other end. And here's a chance for McInally. So Charlton, with that goal by the man now sitting it out, Michael Bennett, have the lead. What can Aston Villa do about that? We've got just under 4 minutes to play. Punch shot. And it's as far as Daly from Peake. Well played by Daly. This is Williams. Daly tries to go in for it. Hunt. Well won by John Humphrey. Oh, look at this. It's Carl Leeburn all on his own against Nigel Spink. to Lieben. Good goal for Carl Lieben. Charlton lead 2-0 and are in a powerful position now. Well played here, because the goalkeeper drove him wide, but he still steered the ball in. There's lots of excitement over there on the Charlton substitutes bench, because they can see here a path into Wednesday's final. This is David Hunt trying to get Villa back into things, and Bob Boulder seems unbeatable at the moment. Look at this, they've got Lieben again. Villa are risking everything and they've got nobody back. Lieben, Humphrey. No option really, Aston Villa. Two goals down, just over 2 minutes to go. They've got to throw everybody forward, and Charlton able to break away at times with Lieben unmarked. This is Paul Mortimer. Peak. And here's Lieben again, hits the post. Another chance for him. Well, he scored two against Newcastle, Lieben. He's got one more here. This is McAnally for Villa. Still McAnally, good run. There's grit in the way. Birch's shot crashes against the plexiglass above the crossbar. Birch again. And out to Daly. Good save, Boulder. McAnally, Birch, and Boulder again. He did. Well, Charlton, Lenny Lawrence down there knows that they're about a minute and a half away. This is Hunt. And their lead of 2-0 surely looks good enough. He's changing his players over every few seconds now, Lenny Lawrence. In fact, both teams have made a substitution. And Aston Villa know they've got to score very quickly. And then they're going to get another one. And instead, it's Charlton on the attack with Lieber. They'd have to get two in just over a minute now, Villa, to save themselves. This is Mortimer. Left, Mortimer's shot, it's going to come out to Lieben. Two players in support, good play by Charlton. They're getting their own players around the man on the ball, giving him a chance to just push it aside to another red shirt. That's the way to play when you're two up in soccer six. Don't give the ball away. Peak, Mortimer, and Lieben is free again. Just over 30 seconds, Charlton two up. And I would say now Aston Villa are out of it. This is Shirtliff. Britt. Peak. Oh, well played. Lieben. He just wants to keep the ball. He knows that they're very close now, Charlton, to winning the Sunday night final.
Last 10 seconds.
Lieben again. Oh, really good play. Can he finish it in the last few seconds? Nigel Spink was there, and the hooter goes to signal that Charlton Athletic, Lenny Lawrence and Mike Flanagan, they're delighted, as are the young supporters. They've earned themselves £21,000 tonight, Charlton, and that's quite a windfall for them. And nice to see a club who've often been down near the foot of the First Division, nice to see them doing so well in this Guinness Soccer Six competition.
Lenny, congratulations. You got pretty excited there.
Yeah, I mean, it was, I lost my voice. Obviously, we've never been before, we didn't know what to expect, but the lads took to it very quickly and very well, and, you know, obviously, in the final, and two goals up with a few minutes to go, you know, I did get a bit excited, but, you know, credit to the boys, they played really well.
Villa had looked very impressive in their qualification from Group A, hadn't they?
Yeah, they looked the best team. They won their group quite easily, in actual fact, and, you know, we were a little bit anxious, but, you know, once we got settled down, I thought we were worthy winners in the end.
How did you approach these soccer sixes?
Well, I've seen them on the television before, but we've never been involved. Only one or two of our players had even played in them before. So we had a little practice last Tuesday at our training ground, albeit outside, and marked the pitch out as it was, and listened to what the man said beforehand and did it. I think the key to it is the substitutions. You know, it's very physically demanding. And I think if you don't bring people on and off at the right time, they can get tired and make mistakes at either end and cost you the game. But I'd like to think we got that right, and everybody in our team played their part.
And back on Wednesday for the final stages.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just delighted. I mean, the club hasn't had a lot of publicity lately because we've had a bad time in the First Division with injuries and what have you. And I'm just delighted for the players and everybody connected with the club that at long last we get the publicity for being successful and for the right reasons.
Good luck for Wednesday night.
Thanks very much.
Well, the Soccer Six off and running with some really terrific action, and well done, Charlton, deservedly through to the final stages on Wednesday evening when they'll join the seeded sides, Liverpool, Wimbledon and Nottingham Forest. Now, later this evening, we'll get two
and
more...
And John Motson is the commentator.
On their different roads to recovery, Bruce Grobbelaar and Jan Molby are in the starting lineup for Liverpool, along with Alex Watson and the captain, Peter Beardsley. As for Charlton, already with one night's experience here, it's Bob Boulder, John Humphrey, Peter Shirtliff, Steve Gritt, Paul Mortimer and Carl Leburn, the 19-year-old who scored some useful goals when they won their playoff. So how well will Peter Beardsley display his skills on this surface? Should suit him. Referee for this opening match of the night is Roger Dilks, and Liverpool in the familiar red are playing from the right, with Jan Molby getting his first touch. And number three there is John Jeffers. It was played back by Dernin to Molby. Dernin again. Jeffers, number three. Beardsley to his right. Jeffers shot. Humphrey got in the way. Slimline Molby. The block was by Shirtliff. Charlton in the all grey. Leburn, number 10. John Jeffers is 20 years old. Local lad. As indeed are five of the Liverpool squad tonight. Come through the ranks at Anfield. It's the first time Liverpool have played in this Soccer Six. So we'll see how well they adjust. Here's Beardsley. Well, Shirtliff can't play the ball back to his goalkeeper. That's forbidden if you've received it from him. If you play the ball directly back to your keeper, then you go into the sin bin. And the other rules, including the sixth man rule, you must leave a player in the opposing half of the field at all times. Here's Beardsley. Dernin, who was on loan to West Bromwich Albion a little while ago, scored a couple of goals there. John Dernin, this is Beardsley. And Charlton with Paul Mortimer. That was a free kick against Jan Molby for obstructing Paul Mortimer. Number two is Humphrey. And number six is Steve Gritt. Mortimer. Gritt again. He's got Leburn in the middle. Number 10. Bruce Grobbelaar out. Alex Watson defending well for Liverpool. Now it's Beardsley. Dernin, the man up front, and he's got past Shirtliff, he's got past Boulder, still John Dernin. Shirtliff with the tackle, won back by Beardsley. This is Dernin. Beardsley again. Molby's just behind him. The two experienced players combining for Liverpool. Here's Beardsley again. Charlton have pulled as many players back as they're allowed. This is Dernin. They must leave one in the other half. Molby. Jeffers. Back to Molby. And Jan Molby has scored. Well, that's an impressive start to his comeback in the public eye. The Liverpool substitutes watching as Jan Molby opens the scoring here. He certainly lost some weight, and he looked sharp there when he drove that left-foot shot inside Bob Boulder's near post to give Liverpool the lead. Shirtliff for Charlton. Watson for Liverpool. Dernin, nice turn. Fouled by Gritt. So, a good start here for the First Division champions. Here's the goal scorer. Beardsley. That was a good effort as well. That's John Lenny Lawrence's team here, a goal behind and very much on the defensive as Steve Gritt gets a foot to that. Molby again into Dernin. Beardsley just behind him. Dernin again. And Jeffers with the shot. Good save by Boulder. Well, Liverpool have started here as though they mean business. This is Beardsley. Dernin in the middle. And John Humphrey for Charlton. Well won back by Molby. Back heel to Dernan. Beardsley. There's no restriction on head height, as there might have been in the old five-a-side football. As long as the ball stays within the playing area, you just carry on. This is Jan Molby. And you can use the boards to good effect, playing a wall pass to get by an opponent. John Jeffers on the far side. Beardsley. Don't think the ball's been out of the Liverpool possession for more than a few seconds so far. They've controlled the game right from the start. And Paul Mortimer will be penalised, will he? Yes. Molby was the man who was fouled. Charlton have made a quick substitution. Andy Peake has come on, wearing number 9 for Charlton. There's Molby for Liverpool, and here's Peter Beardsley. Dernan waiting in the centre. That was Peake. Ronnie Moran there with the Liverpool team tonight. And here's Beardsley. And Charlton having to defend pretty desperately in this opening half. One behind. Here's Mortimer for them. Lee Burns up front. Jeffers intercepts. And Grobbelaar with a very intelligent throw. That really has put John Dernan away here for Liverpool. Bob Boulder called into action again. 2.5 minutes left in the first half. Liverpool lead Charlton by 1-0. And they've brought on Mick Marsh, number 9 of Liverpool, a 19-year-old in place of Jeffers. This is Lee Burn for Charlton. Beardsley for Liverpool. Here's Molby. Marsh has gone to his left. And Dernan on the far side. That's a good goal again. And Liverpool here have taken over. John Dernan scored that one. And well created by Jan Molby. Just look at the space. And Dernan's finish so assured. Molby has scored one and made one. And Liverpool lead by 2-0. 2 minutes left in the first half. And Charlton suddenly getting an education. In line, Michael Bennett coming on as a sub. Now Lee Burn. Don't forget, the managers can put their subs on at any time they want. There's a squad of 10. Number 4 there is David Campbell for Charlton, but he's missed out. And Dernan's through again against Bob Boulder. And Liverpool go 3-0. Well, they're well pleased down there. And John Dernan, now back at Anfield after his loan to the Hawthorns, slides his second goal past the Charlton keeper, Bob Boulder. Excellent finishing. Liverpool lead by 3-0. Now what are Charlton going to do about this? Peake across to Lee Burn. Here's a chance. Oh. Corner will be given. Lenny Lawrence's side was so impressive when they won the first playoff here on Sunday night, but having started here against the seeded team, Liverpool, they suddenly find themselves 3 goals down, and we still haven't reached half-time. David Campbell will take the corner for Charlton. They've got young Peter Evans on now, Charlton. That was his pass to Peake. And Grobbelaar's down there to save. First from Peake and then from Bennett. Alex Watson, Dave Watson's brother. Mike Marsh on the far side. 1 minute left in the first half, and a risky pass by David Campbell. Here's Peter Shirtliff for Charlton. Well, a whirlwind start here by Liverpool. One or two of the players may be unfamiliar to the nation at large, but they've obviously learned their trade with these small-sided games at the training ground at Melwood. Charlton on the attack for the moment. This is Shirtliff. Well played. Campbell now for Charlton. And there's one back, surely, yes, Michael Bennett. Put away by 19-year-old Michael Bennett for Charlton. Campbell really used the boards well, and Bennett slid it in to make it 3-1. And Liverpool have brought on 19-year-old Charlie Boyd, wearing number 4. A midfield player. Beardsley nearly in on that.
David! 3-1, Liverpool, Charlie Boyd.
Lots of money at stake tonight in this prestigious tournament with over £250,000 at stake overall. And Liverpool have come determined, it would seem, to win first prize, because at half-time in this opening group match, Ronnie Moran's team lead Charlton by 3-1. It's often said in football circles that Liverpool's training consists of lots of small-sided games, and that would appear to be genuinely valuable when it comes to a competition like this. Charlie Boyd, number four, getting Marsh on his way here for Liverpool. Boyd again. Mouldy's up front. Here's Marsh. Back again to Boyd. Mouldy. And Marsh. Gets it back from Beardsley. And Liverpool, as they would normally, keeping possession, passing the ball sensibly, not giving Charlton very much space to win it back that they might now. This is Peter Evans. Came off Alex Watson. And Watson again. Now then, did a Liverpool player come back into his own half there? I rather think that Mike Marsh is the offender. You must leave a player in the opposing half. And to the sin bin goes 19-year-old Mick Marsh for 2 minutes. Poor Mortimer. And Charlton beginning to settle a bit now. This is Grit. Oh, and Humphrey with a chance. It's a goal. Well, that 3-goal lead has been reduced to one, and John Humphrey is the scorer for Charlton. Bruce Grobbelaar unable to cover the near post area there. It was Stevie Grit with the shot, and in it went from Humphrey. So Charlton stage a recovery, having been overwhelmed by the way Liverpool opened, and going 3-0 down. They're back now, thanks to that goal, to 3-2. Liverpool still waiting to get their suspended player back on the surface. For the time being, it's John Humphrey again for Charlton. Lee Burns there. Oof, good job Grobbelaar stopped that, because Steve Britt was waiting to equalise. Here's Peter Shirtliff. We're into the last 5 minutes. It's a really good match. Lee Burn. Away by Watson. Lee Burn again. Liverpool will be back to full strength any second. Lee Burn again. And Mortimer and Lee Burn. And a deflection. I think it was off Alex Watson. It's 3-3, and Charlton are back in business. Alex Watson really couldn't do much about that. Lee Burn has the shot, and I think it's got to be an own goal. I think you'll find that when Lee Burn hits this, it wasn't actually necessarily going to go in, but Watson's deflection took it wide of Grobbelaar. It's an own goal, and in this opening match, it's 3 goals apiece after Liverpool had led 3-0. Entertaining stuff here. Liverpool have brought on number two, Nick Tanner, but for the moment it's Steve Grit away for Charlton and Lee Burn. And Grit, oh, it's 4-3. Would you believe this? The South London boys have staged a quite astonishing comeback. And from 3-0 down, they're now in the lead. This is Lee Burn again, and Stevie Grit, the experienced player, tucks the ball in the net, and there's no stopping Charlton. This is Humphrey. Oh, we've still got nearly 4 minutes to go. Goodness knows what the score's going to be at the finish of this one. But it's very much what Soccer 6 should be about. And Lenny Lawrence and Mike Flanagan down there must have thought their team were dead and buried at one stage in the first half. Now they've scored 4 times, and Watson for Liverpool tries to set John Durnin away. They're now looking for the equaliser. Tanner, the blonde lad, defender. But they don't want people defending at the moment, Liverpool, and Morby's got caught there. Lee Burn to Grit. Peter Beardsley away from Mortimer. Durnin's in the centre. It's still Beardsley, and Bob Boulder's there. Bob Boulder, a former Liverpool goalkeeper, by the way, playing against the club that he used to be with when he was the understudy to Grobbelaar for a while. This is Mouldy. So it'll mean a lot to Bob Boulder and to Lenny Lawrence if Charlton can hold on to this lead. Tanner for Liverpool. Durnin.
Thanks. David, Pete.
it's a tiring game, and they need the breather. That is David Campbell. This is Mortimer. Ball. Campbell and Mortimer combining. Mortimer's shot against the plexiglass. Campbell! David Campbell, the Northern Ireland international, used to be with Nottingham Forest, now very much with Charlton. And look at this, the plexiglass presenting him with the chance off the rebound. 5-3 to Charlton. John Humphrey. And the way this game was conceived, Soccer Six, this is exactly what really entertains the crowd. And there's another one for Campbell on Grobbelaar. I think Grobbelaar will have to call out an own goal. He was unlucky. They can't believe it down there. David Campbell is the Charlton player who gets their touch here. But look at this, off the boards, own goal Grobbelaar. So two own goals here by Liverpool. And it's 6-3 to Charlton. After Liverpool had led 3-0. Poor old Bruce. Dern in for Liverpool. They've brought on their number 8, Jim Magilton, of Liverpool, who's a 19-year-old Irish lad, a midfield player. This is Tanner. Another new name, Beardsley. Dern in. Oh, could have had the hat-trick and missed it. Tanner. You can't take your eyes off this match. Tanner again. We're approaching the last 10 seconds. I think it's pretty fair to say Charlton have won it in quite amazing circumstances. Lenny Lawrence and Mike Flanagan down there will be absolutely thrilled to bits. What about that? The league champions, Liverpool, their first experience of Soccer Six. They must have thought it was easy when they led 3-0, but they reckoned without Stevie Gritton Charge, and that's a fabulous comeback. A really good game for the crowd to enjoy. And would you believe the final score? Liverpool 3, Charlton Athletic 6.
Astonishing fight-back victory for Charlton, and a win in their next match would put them in the final. That next match was against West Ham.
Well, one of the prices that West Ham had to pay for their victory in the playoff last night was that veteran goalkeeper Phil Parks was injured. Got a cut in his elbow in one of the early matches, so Alan McKnight takes over in goal. The rest of the starting lineup: Potts, Gale, Ince, Kelly and Keane. And Charlton, after that marvellous match against Liverpool, have every reason to feel confident, and they're starting with Boulder, Humphrey, Shirtliff, Grit, Mortimer and Leeburn. Alan Flood is the referee. West Ham in claret and blue. Playoff winners last night. They've stayed up, obviously, in Manchester for the last 24 hours to take part in the finals. And here for them is Tony Gale. Bob Boulder behind it. Well, Charlton must be oozing with confidence after scoring 6 times against Liverpool from a position of 3-0 down. They've begun by just pushing the ball about and finding space on the far side with Shirtliff. Leeburn, it's a goal. Straight through Alan McKnight from Carl Leeburn. This tall 19-year-old who Charlton picked up from the Lewisham area, right on their old doorstep, as it were, South East London, tucked that ball underneath Alan McKnight. Here's Ince. Gale. Oh, penalty. Shirtliff on Gale. A smile on the face of Peter Shirtliff, but there's no question the referee was right, as I think you'll see from this. Tony Gale was definitely brought down. Kevin Keane to take the penalty against Bob Boulder. Equalises. 1-1. And West Ham pull things round in this London derby. Beautifully struck. One each. Four minutes left in the half. Here's Steve Gritt. And now it's Lieber. I was talking to Michael Norris, the Charlton chairman, before this evening's entertainment started, and there's a lot of talk of them still going back to play in the borough where they really belong, down there in Greenwich. But for the moment, in this indoor game, they're level with West Ham. Paris, George Paris, who's just come on. And also for West Ham now, Julian Dix, wearing five, is on the surface. There he is. Not quite. Interception was by John Humphrey. He's got Leeburn to his right and Bennett to his left. Steve Gritt coming short. So is Shirtliff here. Michael Bennett still there. Shirtliff looked for Leeburn instead. And here's a break. Two against one. Good chance for West Ham. They're clean through. Steve Potts. Oh! Well, I think that was a defender finding himself in a forwards position. Steve Potts getting right underneath it. It was a very good opening for West Ham, that. And a let-off for Charlton. Charlton, of course, play at Selhurst Park these days, sharing with Crystal Palace, but I know that the club's real supporters still feel they belong back in the Greenwich area, where, of course, they did used to occupy the valley. Number six there is George Paris for West Ham. And number nine for Charlton is Andy Peake. Humphrey. Oh, he went all the way there, John Humphrey. He's been a most effective player here for Lenny Lawrence and Mike Flanagan. John Humphrey has scored three goals, even though he's normally a fullback. He's acquainted himself well with this indoor football, and he's got the finishing touch. 2-1 to Charlton. So Alan McKnight, who's come in to replace Phil Parks tonight in goal for West Ham, has been beaten twice. Bob Boulder, meantime, clears his lines. Now then, that ball went from one third to the other without bouncing or touching another player. That's what they call the three-line rule. And it has to be a free kick indirect to West Ham. This is Dix. Gale. And Ince. Oh, good clearance by Peake. Just bear in mind, if the ball is played from one third to the other, it has to either touch the surface or another player on the way through. And Boulder's kick there didn't. Here's Ince. Charlton do cover well back there. They've learned a few lessons playing here this week. West Ham have come back once. Can they come back again? And this is Campbell for Charlton. Peter Evans is in the attack as well. Here's Michael Bennett. Campbell. Bennett! Goal! Well, there's no stopping Charlton, is there? They really have adapted to this sort of football. And here, Bennett starts the move. It goes to Campbell. That's good use of the plexiglass. And Bennett's on hand to tuck that one in off the post and put Charlton into another commanding position. 3-1, and we're in the last minute of the first half, and if it stays like this in Charlton's favour, then they would qualify for tonight's overall final. Here's Ince for West Ham. What can they do about it? That's what they can do. Exactly that. Paul Ince, smashing finish. Bob Boulder, well beaten. That's good, close skill, and what a good strike there as he fell backwards from Paul Ince. 3-2. Andy Peake. David Campbell making a run across here, number four. Michael Bennett inside to Paul Mortimer. Oh, it's opening up for Mortimer. Oh, and can they do it? They can. It's David Campbell, and Charlton are two clear again. An easy goal in the end for Campbell, because Mortimer's shot, after he got past Potts, squeezed it past the goalkeeper, and Campbell only had to just steal that into the unguarded net. 4-2 to Charlton. Here's George Paris for West Ham. Keane, Paris. Well, I don't know if Charlton are going to create some kind of scoring record tonight. Six against Liverpool, four against West Ham. And here's Michael Bennett, who's trying to make it five. And he has! It's raining goals here. And most of them are coming from Charlton Athletic. Bennett broke away there from all the defenders and finished in style. It was Paul Ince who tried to hold him off and couldn't. And that really is powerful finishing by 19-year-old Michael Bennett. We've still got 5.5 minutes left, and it's 5-2 to Charlton. Lee Burns back on the surface. Here's Humphrey. Shirtliff. Well, can Charlton now equal their score against Liverpool? That's the question. It's called Soccer Six. Here's Humphrey. Going to be a minor miracle if West Ham get back into this. And this result, if Charlton hold the lead, would also eliminate Liverpool, by the way. Here's Julian Dix for West Ham. They've got 3.5 minutes to make up the leeway. Foul by on David Kelly by David Campbell. So what can West Ham create from this? Dix. Charlton made a substitution. This is Ince. In fact, it was Andy Peake who came hurrying on there to help defend. This is Dix. Four is Gale. Oh, that was Keane's shot. Well dealt with by Bob Boulder. Got down quickly. Back again to Gale. Into Kelly. Boulder comes all the way out. And Charlton can break possibly here. Oh, spot of blocking on the boards maybe. Referee lets play go on. Here's Dix.
Well, pull it! Shut! Great!
Well, Mike Flanagan there, a former Charlton player, now the club coach. 2.5 minutes to go. The score is 5-2 to Charlton, and Carl Leeburn here. With backup from Humphrey. Lee Byrne again, they've got a man over if they can find him. It's Shirtliff. And that is number six. Well, I didn't know that Charlton were going to take the title of the competition this literally. Six against Liverpool and now six against West Ham. Peter Shirtliff, the captain, got this one. And a nice tidy finish it was too, inside the near post.
And it finished 6-2 to Charlton. Charlton into the final. The West Ham-Liverpool match was of no consequence, but just for the record, West Ham won it 3-0. Now for the other group. Forest, the defending champions. Wimbledon. Manchester, Nottingham Forest, the title holders, against free scoring but unexpected opposition in Charlton Athletic. John Motson, the commentator.
Defending champions Nottingham Forest won last season's Soccer Six final on penalties. Ronnie Fenton and Liam O'Kane have picked that starting lineup. I wonder if Brian Clough is watching at home. The six shooters from South East London can top up their total prize money to over £50,000 if they win this final. And that's quite big money for Charlton. In fact, it's equivalent to three times the amount they took through the gate when they played Nottingham Forest in their last home league game. Referee for the final is Joe Worrell. It's Charlton in grey, playing from left to right. And an indication of the commitment of these two clubs to the Soccer Six tournament for this Guinness top prize is that both chairmen are here. Maurice Roweth of Nottingham Forest and Michael Norris of Charlton Athletic, both in the crowd. Here's Steve Gritt down on the surface for Charlton. John Humphrey. Shirtliff, Gritt, Forrest just grouping behind the ball. They've got to leave one man up, of course, that's Franz Carr. And quite good crowd involvement in this final, even though it's a southern team and a Midland side. Here's Gritt. Humphrey. This is Shirtliff. Charlton starting by just stroking the ball around, keeping possession. This may be a chance for Mortimer. He turned nicely. Good block by Darren Wassell. This is Gritt. Now Humphrey. It's going to go out to Paul Mortimer again. Steve Gritt. Oh, good save. Steve Sutton fingertipped that one away from Stevie Gritt. good start to the final. And down there, waiting to come on, all the other players in these 10-man squads. Here's Humphrey. Wide again for Shirtliff, the captain of Charlton. Grit. Oh, another one, and the same again for the goalkeeper. Leeburn goes in for the rebound. Well, Steve Grit's firing them in from distance, and Steve Sutton seems equal to the task. So now, a change of emphasis as Nottingham Forest build up. Pierce. And again the England fullback, Neil Webb's over on the far side. Darren Wassell wearing five. Carr. Pierce. And he's on his other foot this time. Well, it's Ronnie Fenton watching there from the side. 4 minutes left in the first half of the final. Here's Humphrey. Substitution being made by Charlton, Andy Peake coming into the action. This is Grit. Bit of space, in fact, over on that side for Peake. He's got Grit square. Well, both these teams showing that they know a bit about defending in soccer six as well as attacking. Here's Peake. Mortimer far side, number eight. Challenged by Wassell. Now can Grit get another shot in here? He's tested Sutton twice. This is Humphrey this time. Leeburn goes in for the header and Wassell did enough to put him off. There's Lenny Lawrence, whose team have adjusted so well to this sort of football. And full marks to him. He's encouraged them to take the competition seriously. And here they are in the final. Holder just clearing things up there for Charlton. Now then, Carl Leeburn away from Des Walker. That's a powerful run by the big man, and Mortimer's there, and Charlton are in front. Delight down there among the substitutes and coaches. And Paul Mortimer follows in here. Leeburn hits the boards deliberately. That's the ideal way, really, of scoring in soccer six. You eliminate the defenders and the goalkeeper really like that, allowing the forward to run onto it and score. Here's Franz Carr, nearly equalised. Paul Mortimer, the 20-year-old, has scored the first goal in the final. That's a free kick. It was Des Walker who's gone down. Leeburn, who made the goal, has come off now. We haven't had any injuries in Soccer 6 this week here in the GMEC, so we hope that's not going to be a serious problem for Des Walker. But he will have to be substituted, and I think it's going to be Terry Wilson, number 9, yes. Pierce! Oh, that wasn't very far away.
Stand, Mort, play!
A couple of minutes left in the first half. Charlton Athletic 1, Nottingham Forest 0. And attention for Des Walker, who's in some pain there. Humphrey. He's got Michael Bennett just inside here. That's a good turn. And a very smart swoop shot for Michael Bennett. Well, there's a sharing a jug there, Des Walker and Neil Webb. But you can see from the perspiration that this is an exhausting game. Half and Nottingham Forest find themselves a goal behind. Tommy Gaynor on the run, and here's Franz Carr, and Gaynor's in there, Carr's in there, equaliser. Just a couple of seconds before the hooter. You can't get closer to half time than that. Franz Carr was just in time here. Look how he made the opening and then suddenly saw the opportunity to go in there and finish it off. Half-time in the final of the Guinness Soccer Six, and the score Charlton Athletic 1, Nottingham Forest 1. So Nottingham Forest now playing from left to right. Franz Klar, who pulled them round just before half-time, is now foraging up there again. Andy Peake with him. There's been a real flavour about this tournament in the GMX these last 4 days. The supporters who've come along and the neutrals have also enjoyed it. This is Webb. The crowd in the arena are kept informed of who's in possession by the commentary of Andy Peebles. And he's not just one of the best disc jockeys in the business, he's also not a bad football commentator. If this was drawn, by the way, it would be penalties. Wedge shot, which is what happened last year when Forest beat Manchester United. But can somebody prevent that from being the way that it should be decided? It's been a high scoring night overall, so perhaps we can reasonably expect more goals as the second half wears on. Lee Byrne for Charlton. And now number 4, David Campbell. Lee Byrne's coming in from the far side, tackled by Pierce. Nottingham Forest's turn now to build up. England international Neil Webb across to Franz Carr. Pierce is joining the attack now, running onto it. Good effort. Oh, and there's Gaynor. Boulder doing well again. Oh, and back only as far as Pierce, Bob Boulder. Pierce is shot, and David Campbell able to get in the way this time. That's a good pass to Andy Peake. That's not bad either to Lee Byrne. Peter Shirtliff, on by Mortimer. This is still Mortimer, and this, oh, it went under Lee Byrne's foot. It was an opportunity for him there. Still might be. Shirtliff, Peake, Campbell. Andy Peake again. Here's Lee Byrne. Mortimer's in the middle. Back again to Shirtliff. Charlton just probing for the opening. With 4 minutes to go. Shirtliff. And finally, Neil Webb is in, but not for long because Charlton regained possession immediately. Andy Peake's shot. Shirtliff. Lee Byrne. Great stop. Oh, splendid stuff by Steve Sutton. Gaynor. Well, Tommy Gaynor did awfully well there. Franz Carr. They crowded him out. Campbell. There's Lee Byrne, the target man again for Charlton, up against Darren Wassell. Well, Charlton are having more of the game, there's no doubt about that. This is Shirtliff. He's got it. And the team that Lenny Lawrence has brought here are back in the lead through their captain, Peter Shirtliff, who steered that under the legs, through the legs and under the body of Steve Sutton. Substitutions being made. Franz Carr, just over 3 minutes. Charlton Athletic 2, Nottingham Forest 1. Carr for Forest. Des Walker is back on the arena, even though he was injured in the first half. And it's a break on the far side by John Humphrey. Now, can Forest, the defending champions, save their crown here? It's Carr on the ball, it's Webb making the forward run. He's a little anxious now. Peake. Is the Guinness Trophy going to go down to South East London? That was a good ball out to Peake by Bennett. And it's Bennett again. There goes Lee Byrne. There, and Bennett's waiting. He's there. Oh, again Sutton Bennett. And Steve Sutton performing heroics, which he did last year too here. This is Gaynor. Last 2 minutes now. Carr, Forest still 2-1 down. Gaynor. He's gone past Shirtliff, and a good stop by Boulder this time. They're looking up anxiously, Charlton, at the clock, which everybody in the arena can see. It's a corner to Nottingham Forest. Headed away by John Humphrey. Shirtliff. We're having thrashed Liverpool. Charlton now find themselves in a winning position in the final. Shirtliff. Now, if they don't give the ball away, Charlton, there's every prospect that they're home and dry, because Forest are having to just wait to get possession back, and there can only be about a minute left. Bennett. Peak. Shirtliff. Humphrey. Still Charlton moving around. Forest have just got Franz Carr left up front. They've just desperately got to win the ball back to try and create another chance for themselves. This is Lee Byrne. Shirtliff directing operations, a bit short for Humphrey, and now Forest are in. Great chance up front if they can find Carr. Peake got back awfully quickly. Last 30 seconds, Carr. Well, what a climax here to the Guinness Soccer Six final. Charlton Athletic 2-1 up against Nottingham Forest. Last 15 seconds. Oh, they're giving Boulder a bit of work to do there, his own players. And the spectators are counting down the seconds. Darren Wassell is the time for Forest. Carr. It's all over. A smile on the face of Lenny Lawrence and his players. Peter Shirtliff leads Charlton Athletic to a trophy that they're quite delighted to have won. And what popular champions I think we're going to find they are, because Charlton went about this tournament in the right manner from the moment they arrived on the first day, and they thoroughly deserve the reward, which incidentally is over £50,000 in their case, because they get £30,000 for winning tonight. There was £21,000 for their performance in the qualifying group and the playoff. So there you are, it's worth three home gates at Selhurst Park. And don't forget, Charlton are champions. They were 3-0 down here tonight to Liverpool and beat them 6-3. And now in the final, they beat Nottingham Forest 2-1. Well done, Lenny Lawrence. The climax to a highly successful Guinness Soccer Six tournament for 1988. And there are the new champions.
First trophy of the season, and the first trophy in many a long season, going to Charlton Athletic. Mustn't leave without reminding you of match of the day, the road to Wembley on in their opening match and go on to win the competition. That's what Charlton did tonight, the kind of strange thing that happens in Soccer Six. Good night.